We've got a warehouse and it's our new home base. And I am going to give you a guide right through the space. I thought I had the keys. I don't have the keys. Have you got the keys?
Does any gringo have them?
Hey.
Thank goodness. We've got to get inside. Have you got keys?
Yeah, the keys, gringo.
You don't have the keys?
Well, no. I don't have them.
How are we going to do a show without the keys?
Well, let me try Amanda. Maybe she's got the keys.
She has a private number. She won't answer you.
She got blocked.
Yeah, blocked.
Bother you.
Sorry, this is very boring, but I
didn't sign any order.
Hi, you've reached McGill Mastery. Please leave your name and number and you...
Care to explain?
I don't know. Well, people use my, you know, since I won the jungle, people use my name in the answer machines.
Very confusing.
No.
Can we move off the street corner?
Well, I want to go inside.
Looks like you're up for adoption.
What do you mean?
You're the adoption guy.
Well, no. What, funny you should mention that.
I know. It's in the script.
I've got a few tips around adoption.
People or?
What do you mean?
Well, not people. Animals.
Really?
While we're waiting, should we check it out?
Yeah, let's have a look. Yeah.
During the whole coronavirus crisis, I guess a lot of the focus has been on human health, justifiably, but my focus for a lot of the time has been on animal health and what we can do in terms of extra animals being surrendered, can animals contract coronavirus, and what's going to happen if animal shelters have to shut down. So coming here, we're going to have a look inside the RSPCA headquarters for Sydney, which is in Yagoona here, and try to see how they're coping. Are there extra surrenders? What are they doing to find these animals new homes? And hopefully meet a few little characters who can go to homes and live out a positive, happy life, and maybe even provide someone who's in isolation with a bit of extra company. So let's go in now. So this is kind of the epicenter of this whole situation. We've got a dog here whose name is Larry. He's obviously one of the longer term residents, and you know, it's nice to get to know them, not to understand sort of what makes them tick. I think the wiggly bum is often what a lot of people look for in a dog, and the romantics are catered for with the long walks along the beach. So this is the sort of character, and you look into those little eyes there, and these are the sort of dogs you want to find a home for, because we don't really know how long this whole situation goes on for, and it's not really a nice place to be. You're just stuck in a cage, so we're gonna move on through. So there is another option. If potentially you're not ready for a full-blown adoption and you're not really sure if you can afford the long-term requirement, you can actually do foster care. So this is often a nice midway step, and some of the animals that either can't handle life in a shelter or with people who aren't too sure about their own future, they've obviously still got to pass all the assessments and make sure they're suitable owners and foster carers, but that's kind of like a midway step. How are you coping with everything? You're obviously quite busy.
We have been very busy. Lots of adoptions. It's been really good.
But you have a few puppies that we absolutely need to see, right?
Yeah. Yep, absolutely.
Can we have a look at them?
Yeah, for sure. I'll take you down.
This is kind of the holding area for dogs that are up for adoption. We've got one guy in the background who's pleading to find the perfect home. He wants a swimming pool, 2 acres, and a couple of sheep. I don't really understand the sheep reference. Oh, and here we go.
This is Boots.
Hello, Boots.
Hey.
And how did Boots come to be here?
Boots was surrendered to us. His owners couldn't afford basic care anymore, so that's how he ended up here.
And so he's looking for adoption right now?
He is. He's available. He's waiting for his forever home.
I mean, he seems pretty chilled out.
Yeah, he's a classic Labrador.
So all the dogs here, like Boots, they go through a behaviour assessment.
They do, yeah.
And then from that, you learn what sort of family they're most suited to. Is that
yeah,
right?
Yeah, exactly right.
Well, Boots, you're beautiful.
He is.
And fingers crossed for the future, huh? We'll let you rest. Tough day. Oh, now this isn't the sort of dog I expect to see at a shelter.
Yeah, this is Percy.
So he's a poodle cross, right?
He is, yeah. Contrary to what people think, we see all breeds walk through the shelter.
Do you know where he came from?
Yeah, he was actually seized by our inspectors.
Yep.
He came from a puppy farm background,
right.
Unfortunately.
So for Percy, how do you find a home for him?
Obviously, coming from a puppy farm, he hasn't had that human interaction that we would like them to have as puppies. So he needs someone that's going to be patient and understanding, and a house that's not going to be too boisterous.
Just the easy life.
Yes.
Now, with the risk of COVID-19 around, people can't just lob by and have a look at him, can they?
So no.
How do people even get to know Percy?
We've started virtual adoptions.
Really?
Mm.
So it's your equivalent of online dating?
Yes.
Yeah?
Yeah, that's exactly right. People can jump online to our website, rspcansw.org.au, and they can check out their profiles. So they've all got a profile on there, a bit about them, their likes and dislikes, and how they can get to know them more.
Do they get to choose a really flattering photo of themselves from like years ago that doesn't really match with them now?
We try not to.
The important thing here is that there are actually a lot of empty cages, so a lot of the dogs are actually finding homes really quickly, which is really encouraging. A lot of people are deciding to self-isolate, but with company. This is Jace, our sound recordist, keeping his 1.5 metre distance. But the good thing about a dog is the fact that you don't need to keep that distance. You can actually get that affection, that company, and feel a little less lonely. And we've got four very naughty guys here who are weeing for Australia in there. And bravely, I'm about to go inside and attend to some business. Not their kind of business, like actual veterinary business. So, see you later. Right, time for some serious business.
Come here. Hello, guys.
Hello.
Wow. Oh, you've
had a pat deficiency, have you? Oh, and a lick deficiency. Whoa, right in the mouth.
Okay. In a funny sort of way, dogs have become the victims of this crisis, but also the heroes. They've been surrendered in record numbers. They're in need of adoptions, but around the home, they're the perfect antidote to isolation and to loneliness. But you need to make sure it's the right home. You don't want to create a scenario where they're being surrendered further down the track. Come here. What happened? We had a deal. Come on. Yeah? Are you humping? Hey, guys. Guys, we've had the wee, there's poo, and now we've got the humping, huh? Are you showing your worst sides right now? Huh? Or your best sides? You know what I mean? You know what I mean? You're pretty cute. Huh? Don't say anything, but if I was going to adopt a dog, I'd probably adopt you out of this form.
Let's go down the front door and wait for Amanda.
Yeah, you reckon?
Yeah.
Did you like the story, though?
I thought the story was great. Your stories are always good.
I just think it's a relevant topic. You know, yeah, a lot of dogs went through some tough times, but, I mean, how amazing is it? It's actually quite hard to find a dog. I mean, there's a positive outcome here.
There's always a
positive outcome.
With the geese, I really like. We need to get ready for the next.
No, still so
nothing?
No, nothing.
We tried knocking?
I've knocked.
You have knocked?
Yeah, I've done it all.
Knocking
again?
No offence, but do you mind if I just check this?
Try.
Is that like a secret code?
It's not open.
You're dreaming.
Interesting neighbourhood, isn't it? Even the lions have piercings.
alternate neighbourhood.
How good is the living room bed in there, isn't it?
I've got things to do, guys.
What are you up to?
Well, I've got stuff. I have my afternoon nap.
Well, if we had the keys, it might help.
We're all in this together.
Murray, please.
Ben Lee. He's great.
Oh, yeah!
Here.
Well, what are you doing in there?
I've been waiting for you in here.
Didn't hear the door knock much?
No, I didn't. Come on in.
Thank you.
Come on.
We've been here for so long.
Come on.
So confused.
Why are you so beautiful?
Are you attracting all the bees in the neighbourhood? What are you wearing?
So pretty.
Come on in.
Have you got the keys?
Of course I've got the keys.
Why does your answering machine sound like McGill?
I don't know. You can't come in. Not yet anyway. Because you have to tidy up. If you want to come in and see what it looks like in here, you have to join us on the very first night of the living room. Put the kettle on.